In this video, we're going to talk about Excel's date functions. There are three basic things to know about Excel dates before we get started. 1. Excel only recognizes dates on or after January 1st, 1900. So you'll need a special workaround to handle dates between the year 1 and the year 1899. The second thing to know is that Excel uses unique serial numbers to identify each date since January 1st, 1900. So January 1st, 1900 is considered day 1 in Excel's serial numbering system. January 2, 1900 is stored with the serial number 2, the following day is stored as 3, and so on. So for instance, June 1st, 1987, let's see what serial number this is stored as. It's 31929. That means it's been 31,929 days since January 1st, 1900. And the third basic thing to know about Excel dates is that when we change the number format, it doesn't change the value of the number, it only changes the way the number is displayed. Now, if you want to know whether you have access to the functions we're discussing in this video, you can just click Formulas on the Excel ribbon and select the Date and Time drop-down menu from the function library. There are over 20 functions that perform some type of calculation having to do with dates. In this video, we'll share how to use just 6 of them, so you'll get comfortable. These are just the 6 that we think you might find useful right away, but feel free to experiment with the others. So let's start with the date function. Because dates can be written in a variety of formats, there can be misunderstandings when everyone isn't on the same page. So for instance, this list of invoices is sorted by the invoice total. If we wanted to get the sum of the invoices for the last 7 days of the month, that's after June 21st, they're kind of scattered. They're not sorted by date. So we might want to use the SUMIF function. So we get started here in this cell by typing SUMIF, and here's our qualifying range. The criteria we'll want is to say dates that are greater than June 21st. So let's get that condition in the formula. And now we need to use the date function to standardize the date format so that Excel will convert it to the right serial number in the background. So we type date. And for that, we'll need to enter the year, so that's 2021. The month is the 6th month, and the day, the 21st day. So that's our second argument in the SUMIF function. And of course, the range that we want to add is the range in column C, close parentheses. And now we have our total of invoices that were generated after June 21st. Now, officially, for the date function, the year argument can be 1 to 4 digits representing the year. But we recommend that you use all 4 digits to avoid any misunderstandings. For instance, if you enter 21 as the year, let's see what happens. Well, the problem is that Excel has interpreted 21 as the year 1921. So if you really mean 2021, you should enter all 4 digits. Let's take a look at our second function for today. We'll be looking at the NOW function. The NOW function simply returns the serial number of the current date and time. When NOW is used in a cell, a date format that matches your computer's regional settings is applied. The NOW function updates dynamically whenever the worksheet is opened or when formulas are manually recalculated. The NOW function has no arguments, so you just type equals NOW, open and close parentheses, and this is what we get. Excel automatically applied the date setting to this cell, but to change this to a setting that includes the date and time, we can go to the Number Formats dropdown and just select one that includes the date and time. Now remember we mentioned that the NOW function is dynamic. So if you're already in an open worksheet and you want to refresh the date and time, just go to the Formulas tab and click Calculate Now. You can also use the F9 shortcut, or if you're using a Mac, Function F9. So now when we hit Calculate Now, it recalculates and gives us the new time. If you use the Calculate Now option, remember that this will calculate all the formulas in the entire workbook. If you only want to recalculate formulas in the current worksheet, then you'd select Calculate Sheet or Shift F9. The Now function can be used to create formulas that calculate a future or past date and time relative to the current date and time. So for instance, we can have equals now plus 7. This formula calculates the date and time that's exactly 7 days from now. You can also do something like a day and a half from now, like this, 1.5. Or you can do something that's 11 hours from now by typing 11/24. Okay, very similar to the now function is the third function we'll look at, which is the today function. The today function has no arguments either. It returns the current date, and it can be used to create formulas for any number of days before or after today. So it's very similar. We just type today, open and close parentheses. With the today function, the default time is always midnight. So we'll want to change that number format to display the date only. And just like the now function, we can modify the today function to calculate days before or after the current date. We can also combine the today function with other Excel functions to extract a single element from today's date, like the year, month, or day. So we could type equals day, and this means today is the 8th day of the month. We could check the month number by nesting today with the month function. And the same thing applies to the year. With this idea, we can also calculate the number of years elapsed between today and some other date. So let's say we wanted to find out how many years have passed since 1983, and that would be our answer. Let's look at the fourth function, EOMONTH. This one is usually used in financial settings. The EOMONTH function returns the last day of a particular month, and we can use this when we want to force a date to fall on the last day of the month. So in this example, let's say that the investment is set to mature on the last day of the month, 3 years from the investment date. We can use EOMONTH. Here's our start date. And since it'll be 3 years from the investment date, we use 36. But EOMONTH will force this date to fall on the last date of that month. So it returns the serial number. And if we want to get the date, we just change the number format. Now, how about our fifth function, net workdays? This function is used to calculate the number of days between two dates using the start and end days. But net workdays is really cool because it automatically excludes Saturdays and Sundays. And there's also an option to exclude a list of other days too, like holidays. So let's say we want to find out how many working days there will be in the year 2022. We'll use net workdays to calculate. We need a start date, and for this we recommend using the date function so that there's no confusion. So date, the year is 2022. The month is the first month and the first day. We close parentheses to end the date function, type a comma to start our end date. And again, we use date, 2022, 12th month, 31st day. Close parentheses. And we will include the holidays argument because we don't want to count these in our working days. So we highlight that range, close parentheses, and there are 252 working days, not counting holidays and weekend days. One thing that's really cool to remember is that if any of these holidays is a Saturday or Sunday, there's no double dipping. Net workdays doesn't subtract it twice. So that's really cool. So we know that our calculation is accurate. Now we'll call the next function 5.5 because it's almost the same as net work days, but it gives us the flexibility to control which days of the week are considered weekend days. Because of course, in some settings, Saturdays are considered working days. So this other function is called net work days international. And all we do here is to type .intl. That's its own function. There's this argument. The third argument is actually called weekend. Let's get rid of the holidays argument here. So now we have a list of weekend options. The default is Saturday, Sunday, but of course we can have another weekend option. So in our case, let's say only Sundays are considered weekend days. So we'll select 11 as our weekend argument. And we have the same holidays here. Let's see how it changes the number of working days in that year. And now there are 305 working days in the year 2022. Our last function is another cool one. It's the weekday function. Now the weekday function finds the day of the week of a serial number. By default, this function will return a number from 1 to 7, where the number 1 means that that date is a Sunday, 2 means Monday, and so on. But again, you can customize the return type with an optional argument. So here's what the weekday function looks like. There's one required argument and one optional argument. So let's say we use today as our serial number. For the return type, we see a number of options, but if you have a version of Excel before 2010, you'll notice only three return types. That's 1, 2, and 3. Since Excel 2010, the return type options were expanded, so now there's 11 to 17 also. And what this means is that you have more options for which day is designated as your start of the week. So the default is that the week starts on a Sunday and ends on Saturday. But in different settings, there are different days that are considered the beginning of the week. So here's what it looks like if we use the default. It says that today is considered the sixth day of the week. That means today is Friday. But if we changed our return type and said that Monday is the first day of the week, then today would be considered day 5. Now let's go back to the default where Sunday is the first day of the week. You can add the text function to weekday so that it displays the name of the weekday. So we can say text weekday, and the text function carries a second argument, which is the format of the text. So if we wanted to display the weekday name, we can just enter within double quotes DDD, and that will display the three-letter abbreviation of the day of the week. If we want the full day of the week, we need 4 Ds. Now, this only works if Sunday is the first day of the week. If we used another return type, like number 11, this doesn't work. Because, of course, it's returning the number 5, and as far as the text function is concerned, the number 5 would only be associated with Thursday. One workable solution is to use the switch function to declare alternative values for each possible result. So we can use the switch function if Sunday isn't the first day of the week. So we do something like this. And once that's entered, now our number 5 returns the weekday Friday. So that works out great. Now the other date functions in the functions library are mostly variations of these basic ones. So get started with these using the practice file in the description and check out our other Excel tutorials on GoSkills.com.
Ready to learn more about Microsoft Excel? Then check out the full course on GoSkills.com. Click the link in the description.